Faraday, who is the one who is doing a lot of electronical and software solutions, what we are needing here inside the station to be. Many of the computer screens that we can show have been also managed to be here because he has done that programming and processing of many of these things what we are doing. And at the moment, so this is some small example from the like 30 meter height. So what we have, like, I don't know if it's like the actual one, but this is a barely two day like overview of we have the wind direction measured there. We have wind speed, so like the averages. We see there is like quite strong gusts. So this is like the maxima can be quite high. The minima is also in there. And this is all based on the 10 hertz data. So what we are measuring really like 10 times a second. And so you make half an hour average values out of that. So we have here a parameter which is important to say something on the turbulent flow. This is friction velocity. And we have here temperature, which we have then, it's carbon dioxide. And you can see we have here this kind of jumping around it. Then the water vapor concentrations. This is concentration. Then we have a rough flux calculation. So we are calculating short without any correction, just to get an overview that the running in data are in a good shape, that the running in data are in a way that we see that there's no problems. So we make this kind of short flux calculation. So this would be also some similar system is of the mast than in 70 meter height. And then we have next room, which is our nice...
Do you have replication of these kind of towers in other parts of...
In Estonia, not, but there is there are four towers in Finland, and there is one tower in China.
Good.
Doing this kind of measurements, that's it.
Excellent. So
for this kind of measurements, the good thing is like when you can compare, or when you can see from, let's say, transport, we can try to find out what is the transported air mass we see right now here. Was it before north of us, or have been we the first one passing, and other stations can see also what is the difference when it travels over.
So you have in CO2, you have different level, five.
Yeah. We have in the moment five levels measuring here, but we are measuring, this is only a flux system what we have, but we have also what we show them there, what they're in. There is like the gas measurements, and that is sucking down air.
Yeah.
Nice room here.
También miden los típicos monóxido, ozono y costa de exceso.
Ah.
Es decir, bajan acá y analizan el aire.
Oye,
eso, tienen un solo analizador.
Okay, so what happens here? We have gas analyzers. There will come some more gas analyzers in the near future. Some of them are already here, staying and waiting to be installed. At the moment, we have been in this first half year, we have been started with basically build out this manifold system here, which is incoming piping from the mast, which is then distributed, and that we can direct all the measurements going on to the gas analyzers. So we can then slice the time. You measure some minutes, one height, next height, and that you can do over five
heights.
We have a lot of these solutions, what we have been built, something like that is nothing what you can somewhere buy. So that is something we have been ordered from a company to build. We have given them the idea what we want to have from them. So there is like the specification what we give them. We have used in the station a lot of this kind of computer. So that's what you see here. This is basically a Linux computer. It runs on an 8 or 16 gigabyte flash memory card. It has I think it's now a quad core in the newer versions processor in. And we have there this additional board, which is like let us send signals in and out. So
So we have the possibility to know, for instance, when we have a kind of a flow meter going below some limit, we can get an email. And somebody tells us from the station that you should come here, mate, because I am calling for help right now. And things like that. Or we have made one of the, even though we have nice big backup systems, all these two big boxes behind you are the UPSs, but they will not hold the full, let's say, pump system for longer than some 20 minutes. And so what we are doing is when we have a longer power out, so we can switch off, for instance, with this system also remotely, you can give a command and say, okay, now anyway, there will be no power maybe for some hours, because when we have a tree dropped on a line, it may take a day to regain that power line. So it will be some possibility that we can order switch off things, where like coming, where we can then decide, let's say, now the power comes back and we can put... It's also a funny thing what we have learned so far. The most dangerous situation for devices, measurement devices, is not when the power goes off, it's when the power comes back.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So we have just happened to learn that we have now a toilet.
Somebody has been in the toilet. Somewhere in the forest. Good.
Climbing up there?
Stefan and Dmitry.
Okay, they do that by themselves?
Yes, they have the license and they took the climbing courses, so they install all the equipment by themselves. Yeah, it's one. The tower is 130 meters. The highest measurement point is 110.
Okay.
Wow. How was it directed? How was it
built up? Piece by piece. So they put the first part, then they put the second part on. So they had to clear this area.
Was it so the crane or helicopter? Or?
No, there was this thing, I don't know what it's called in English, that puts on top.
This is quite an interesting technology. They put the first piece, then they are using this piece as a basement. They climb up, they rise the neck and put that on the top.
Esto es un de cálculo, no menos de 2 millones de euros. Lo menos.
No, pero esto es, se notaba que había una billulla. Qué lindo teclado el de la Mac. Oh.
No, no, sí, es una maravilla. Por ahí vienen todos los tubos y las cosas.
que los chabones hornen acá. Ah, mirá lo...
¿Dónde está la torre? Esa está la torre.
Juntadores de escoria.
Tienes juntadores de escoria con nosotros.
Sí.
Están lindos, ¿eh?
Tienen una pinta.
Lo que pasa es que está bueno que queda de esta manera. Lo bueno es que al estar puesto así, el agua va para abajo. Sí, y queda seco.
Sí. ¿Perdón? Se ve que no hay vacas acá.
Qué bárbaro, boludo. Si quiero algo así, boludo. Que a un sitio de estudio, ¿sí? Y que uno haga todo esto.
¿Eh? Mirá lo que es.
Yo quiero algo así, man.
Y está atado, no a los árboles, fíjate, al piso.
¿Está al piso?
Sí, fíjate. Porque no está hecho a los cholos. ¿Vamos arriba? Hay dos personas. Hay dos personas. Le echamos la culpa al vino.
Argentina is not visible from here.
Well, maybe 40 meters now. Less.
30 meters.
30.
Most is 130.
Yeah. Wow. How much is this? 2 million euro. It's amazing.
Yeah, it's a big project, but it's even bigger deal to keep it alive, because
yes,
as I remember, it was not too big business to get money to build it, but it's quite difficult to get money to run it.
Yes, and there's a lot of data.
Yeah.
Wow. And I imagine in this place, instruments or something like that. What is the point of this stuff?
I think it's
to measure in height what's happening in the forest, including with the.
I think it's easier to access than this one, because as I heard, the special license you need to climb up
yes.
this tower.
Yes.
For this one, you don't.
Yes.
You can come up here and make your measurements with. Canopy analyzers or whatever, you can put your radiometer here.